Welcome back, everyone. Today we learn about cell structure and organization. First, we will take a look at the structures present in an animal cell and its function. The nucleus is a spherical, double membrane-bound organelle. It controls cell activities such as cell growth and repair of worn-out parts. It is essential for cell division as it contains DNA or chromosomes for making polypeptides and proteins. The cell surface membrane or plasma membrane is a partially permeable, phospholipid bilayer. It controls the movement of substances in and out of the cell. The cytoplasm is the site of most biochemical reactions. The vacuoles, which are small and temporary, are membrane-bound fluid-filled spaces. They contain water, food substances such as sugar and amino acids, or waste products. The rough endoplasmic reticulum, or RER, is a network of flattened membrane-bound sacs, with its surface studded with ribosomes, hence appearing rough. In this electron micrograph, you can see that for the RER there are dots attached to its surface. These dots are the ribosomes. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum, or SAR, is a series of interconnected tubules that has no ribosomes attached. It makes lipids, steroids, hormones, and carries out detoxification. The ribosomes, as can be seen in the diagrams, are responsible for carrying out polypeptide synthesis during translation and can be found in cytoplasm to make intercellular proteins or on the RER to make extracellular proteins. The Golgi body or Golgi apparatus are stacks of flattened membrane-bound sacs not physically connected. They chemically modify proteins made by ribosomes on the ER, packs and sorts them into secretory vesicles. The mitochondria are small, oval double membrane-bound organelle. It carries out aerobic respiration to release energy from glucose. Lastly, the centrioles consists of a pair of cylindrical structures to form spindle fiber during cell division in animal cells. This is an electron micrograph of an animal cell. Moving on to plant cells, the nucleus, cell membrane, and cytoplasm have the exact same structure and function as shown earlier in the animal cell slides. The vacuoles of plant cells are large and central. They are also membrane-bound, fluid-filled space. It contains soluble sugars, pigments, amino acids, or waste products. But it doesn't contain starch. It has a membrane called tonoplast. Plant cells have cell wall, which is made of cellulose and is fully permeable. It protects the cell, gives it a fixed shape and support, which prevents the cell from bursting if it absorbs too much water. Finally, we have the chloroplast. It is a tiny disc-like structure and contains chlorophyll, which is the site of photosynthesis. We also have to know about the cicular transport. Polypeptides synthesized by the ribosomes on the RER and also substances from the SAR are transported to the Golgi apparatus by vesicles. The Golgi apparatus then chemically modifies, packs these polypeptides into secretory vesicles that fuses with the cell membrane to release its content outside the cell. So the flow is as such, from the RER to the Golgi apparatus and then finally to the cell surface membrane. Comparing between the animal and plant cell. Plant cells have cell wall, but animal cells don't have a cell wall. Plant cells contain chloroplast, but animal cells don't contain chloroplast. Finally, plant cells have a large central vacuole, but animal cells have vacuoles that are small and many. Now let's look at the organization of multicellular body. We know that cells are the basic unit of life, hence they are the basic building block. Tissues are a group of cells with similar structures which work together to perform a specific function. An organ contains more than one type of tissue all working together for a specific function. An organ system consists of several organs working together for a common purpose. Finally, an organism is made up of many different organ systems working together. To end this video, we will be looking at cell specialization. In order to perform specific functions more effectively, cells differentiate, meaning they develop special structures into specialized cells. The first specialized cell is the xylem vessels. They are long and narrow, and their walls are strengthened by lignin that prevent the collapse of the vessel. They don't have any crosswalls in protoplasm in their lumen such that there is uninterrupted flow of water and minerals. The second specialized cell is the root hair cell. It is long and has a narrow hair-like extension which increases surface area to volume ratio for faster absorption of water and mineral salts. Lastly, the red blood cell. It has a circular, biconcave shape which increases the surface area to volume ratio to take in and release oxygen at a faster rate. It has no nucleus which enables the cell to store more hemoglobin for oxygen transport. That's all for today. Thank you for the effort to learn with me. Stay tuned for more interesting lessons. See you next time. Bye-bye.